Hey everyone, in this video I will be showing you how to download and install Keycloak and run it locally in Windows. So let's get started. First thing, just Google Keycloak. You'll be getting this first link from keycloak.org. Click it, and here we'll be having the get started. Select it and click on open JDK. Because I'll be showing you run it locally and downloading it as a zip file. If you want to choose any other methods we are having through Docker and other stuff also, you can try it through that also. So I'll be showing you the zip file method. So for this, first we need to have OpenJDK, which is Java. As it clearly says here, we must have OpenJDK 21 installed. So for that, just Google Java download. You'll be having this link from Oracle. Select it. And here we are having Java JDK 21. Click it and select the operating system as Windows. We are having this x64 installer. Click it and the download will be getting started. It is about 164 MB in size. Just be patient till then. So once the download is complete, just open it and click on yes. And we'll be getting this Java development kit setup. Click on next. And this is the default location where Java will be installed. If you want to change it, click on change and just choose the desired folder. So I have changed it. I'll click on OK and select next. And the installation process will begin. Just be patient. And it says it's successfully installed. Just close it. Now we need to go to the folder where we have installed Java. If you had gone through the default installation, it will be in C program files, and here we will be having the Java folder. So in case if you chose custom installation just like me, just go to that folder, and inside Java you will be having this bin folder. Select it and make sure that you are copying this path. Alright, now go to search and type environment. We will be having this edit the system environment variables. Open it and click on environment variables, and here either under user variables or system variables, click on new, and here in the variable name just have it Java underscore home, and in the value just paste this path and just remove the bin. We can add that in that path separately. So it's going to be the entire path except the slash bin. Okay, and after this click on OK. Now you'll be having here path, and click on edit and click on new. Just type here percentage Java underscore home percentage and put a slash like this and add the path bin. Okay, it should be something like this. Be careful with the type of slash that you are using over here. After this just click on OK, and it will be something like this. That's good. Click on OK everywhere. Now go to search, click on command prompt and just run the command java space hyphen hyphen version and hit enter. As you can see, I'm getting the Java version 21 over here. And let's continue with our Keycloak. And next it says we need to download and extract this zip file. I'll click it, and it is about 147 MB in size, so just be patient. So once the zip file has been downloaded, just extract it. And make sure that you are cutting and putting this file in some other drive rather than the downloads, so that you don't delete it in future. Let's just follow these instructions. So it says from a terminal, open the Keycloak 26.3.3 directory, and we need to run this particular command. So I'll just go here. This is my Keycloak folder. Open it. And we need to run this particular command so that it runs kc.bat file. So if I go here inside bin, as you can see, I'm having that KC batch file over here. So we're going to run this. So just place your mouse here and type CMD, open the terminal. Now we need to run this command. This is for Windows. And we'll just put it over here. So this will take some time. Just be patient. So after some time, as you can see here, it says listening on this particular port number. So you can simply copy this and go to a new tab in your browser and paste it. And here you can just remove this zeros and just type here localhost and hit enter. So it should be localhost colon 8080. And here we'll be getting this create a temporary admin user, because this is the first time that we are logging in over here. So we just need to create a temporary admin user. So just add your password and username and make sure that you remember these credentials and click on create user. And that's it. Just select open administration console. And now enter the username and password which we created earlier for the admin and click on sign in. And you'll be taken to the Keycloak master console. As you can see to the top, we are getting a warning because I have logged in as a temporary admin and it's asking me to create a permanent admin account and delete the temporary one. So for this, here you are having the users. Click it, and as you can see, it's showing us our temporary admin that we used earlier. Just click on add user. Just enter the username. I will just go with main admin. And if you want email, first name, last name, you can just add these true. That's up to you. And I'll just click on create. And after adding this, next step is we need to have the password. So just click on credentials, set password, and type the password over here. Click on save and click on save password. That's it. The password has been there. If you want to change it, you can reset the password. Next is going to be the role. Click on role mapping and click on this assign role and select realm roles. And here make sure that you are checking everything and click on assign. And that's it. Now we have given the admin access to our main admin user. And now we can just go to users. And as you can see, I'm not having that temporary mark near the main admin user. So now basically we can just sign out from our temporary admin and then log in into our main admin and then delete it. Don't delete it directly. So click here and select sign out. And now using our main admin credentials, sign in over here and click on sign in. So it says update your password to activate your account. So I'll just update my password and click on submit. And that's it. As you can see, now I am in my main admin and I'm not having that warning over here of using a temporary admin account. And now I can simply go here and click this and select delete. That's it. That user has been deleted. That's the video, guys. Do check the playlist of my channel. There are a lot of videos in programming and AI tools. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.